Hey folks, this is Beston Slaughter. Welcome back to our preview of ARK 2. As promised in the last video, we're going to take a deeper look at the dinosaurs today. We're going to compare them to their predecessors in ARK Survival Evolved. We're going to evaluate them both as a general design, how much do we like the design, and also compared to the real interpretation of the dinosaur as best we know. I want to talk about that very quickly, however. Of course, ARK 2 is set on an alien planet. These are new species of dinosaurs, alien species of dinosaurs, and realism isn't necessarily the goal. So let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Which is your favourite of the bunch? Which is your least favourite of the bunch? I'll definitely let you know mine as we go through. And we're going to kick off with one of the very best. So this is Utah Raptor Prime. This is the ARK Survival Evolved version, and a really good example of how we can take a design, we can make the design more realistic, but also just generally make it better for the sequel as well. As you can see, I mean, that's a hell of a glow up. more than any dinosaur we're going to see today, the Utah Raptor looks substantially better in ARK 2 compared to ARK 1. So what makes it better and what makes it more realistic? Let's take a look. Remember, they're not the same thing necessarily, but often are. So the base of the neck has changed rather dramatically in ARK 1. We have basically a right angle here. The angle at the base of the neck, at the top of the spine for the ARK 1 Raptor is a little bonkers. In ARK 2, this one is leaning forward a little bit and kind of in this threatening pose, but it's much more naturalistic in its shape. We'll come back to that in a little bit. The wrists on the ARK 1 Utah Raptor are pronated, meaning they are pointing down towards the earth, down towards the ground, and then in on themselves. Whereas if you look at the wrists on the ARK 2 Utah Raptor, they're pointing inwards towards the inside of the Utah Raptor, towards the inner, towards the middle, basically, towards each other somewhat, rather than down towards the earth in that kind of very typical movie monster, clawed, curved kind of attack style. The other big noticeable change, of course, is the feathering. We did have feathers on the ARK 1 Utah Raptor. I wonder if they weren't as feathered because fur shaders, etc. weren't quite as good back then. But we've got a weird little mohawk, we've got some feathering down the back, and of course we've got the wings there on the elbow and the arms. In ARK 2, those are all present, but the overall body is much more covered in feathers as well, and it's a much more furry sort of coating. As a Dromaeosaurid, we would expect Utah Raptor to largely be covered in feathers, with possibly, as we can see, this exposed underbelly. This is a really nice, realistic interpretation that also makes the dinosaur look really cool. And finally, if we take a look at the eye, you can see the eye is much larger in the ARK 2 Utah Raptor. Again, this is something fairly consistent in the ARK 2 designs, and also the pupil position has changed, which I think, again, gives it a much more primal and sort of vicious look. So more realistic, but also much more intimidating, which is that not the absolute perfect combination? And we can see there, if we compare it to the Scott Harmon skeletal there, it is pretty damn good. It's pretty similar, and you can see exactly what I mean about the neck shape as well. If this was the ARK 1 Utah Raptor, this would be more like that, whereas we've got this much more gradual snake-like shape here on the skeletal and on the ARK 2 Utah Raptor. Now let's look at Stegosaurus. So this is Stegosaurus Regium from the first game, and we've only got concept art for the ARK 2 version, but they've gone a little wild with it. Now, there are nods to realism here. This is kind of what I was talking about, but it's a common theme in ARK 2's herbivores, from what I've seen so far, that they've amped up the defensive properties of the dinosaurs. They look more rugged, they look more alien, they look more intimidating. I think they're trying to bring the herbivores and carnivores into relative parity rather than the herbivores looking entirely like prey. That's a philosophy I can get behind, and they've just gone a little bit crazy for my liking, but that's okay. So this one, for example, the thagomyza, which is the spikes at the tail, not only do we have lots more of them, but they're also much larger on the new ARK 2 version, which is the one at the top, of course. The plates are again following that same philosophy. They're much larger and also much, much, much more numerous, present now in like four layers or so along the body, up onto the skull, and also on that shoulder at the front on the forelimbs, as you can see. Stegosaurus, by all accounts, would not have had these perfectly symmetrical, perfectly matching sized plates. They would have been a little bit off kilter, they would have changed in size along the body. So that random kind of look that the ARK 2 one has is definitely more in line with the real dinosaur. I just wish they'd maybe toned it down a little bit. I know these are alien dinosaurs, that's okay, that's not what I'm taking an issue with, it's just a little bit too much for me personally. That said, as with all the designs, there are still some nods towards realism, so this is a fairly common thing with dinosaur designs, in that they'll give sauropods, stegosaurids, ankylosaurids, they'll give them feet that resemble that of an elephant. And what I mean by that is that they'll give the dinosaur big toenails and then these toes that you can kind of see. You know, you can see a little gap there, you can see a little gap there, but not really. It's not super clear. And you can kind of see the same over here on the ARK 1 Stegosaurus. Whereas if we go look at the ARK 2 Stegosaurus, you can see the toes are much more individualistic, much more splayed out compared to the ARK 1 iteration. That is much more what we think these feet would have looked like. And this, again, is a fairly consistent thing in the dinosaurs for ARK 2. There's a couple other little things. One of the things I really like about the designs in ARK 2 again is that they're, generally speaking, they're a little bit thicker. So the skull shape, as you can see, is largely identical to the skeletal we've got down here in the bottom left by, again, Scott Harmon. But the body here, we've got the much thicker neck and the body hangs a little bit lower. It's been chonkified a little bit compared to the ARK 1 Stegosaurus. The legs are thicker, etc. So I really like seeing this change in the ARK 2 Stegosaurus, particularly around that sort of neck and upper body shoulder sort of area. I think that looks really effective. And it does look more intimidating. I would personally have taken off some of the plating and toned down the thagomizer a little bit. But you know what? I don't dislike the design overall. Next up, we're going to take a look at Tyrannosaurus Rex. This is Tyrannosaurus Dominium, I believe it's called. But it's called Rex as like a nickname, basically. Now, it's worth noting the ARK 1 Rex did already have a bit of a glow-up. There was a TLC update for the Rex and a few other dinosaurs, a few other creatures, where they changed the design. And again, we can draw some points of comparison here. Again, the wrist pronation you can see on the left-hand side Rex, on our ARK 1 Rex. Like that ARK 1 Utahraptor, the wrists are pointing straight down. The claws are pointing down towards the earth, whereas if you look at the ARK 2 Rex, the wrists are pointing inwards, the claws are pointing in towards the other wrists, which would be over here, doing the same thing. Again, a little nod towards realism, which I really like to see. Of course, we've also got feathering now as well. We now suspect Rex was not as fully feathered as we thought maybe 5 or 6 years ago. I miss the days of the chicken Rex, I'm not going to lie, but the chances are it probably had a smattering of feathering here and there. So again, we can see it kind of moving down the spine, and we can also see some here in the wings on the elbow. These are a little weird looking for my liking. I would have preferred something more like a furry covering, kind of like what we saw on the Utahraptor, rather than this very bushy, large feathering. But this is not even an in-game cinematic, I don't think so. So it's hard to judge the Rex too much from this image. At least the feathers are there. Again, I think that's a positive change overall. The brows above the eye socket are more pronounced in our Rex. Our Rex on the right, actually, I've only just really noticed this, it's kind of partially lipped. The teeth are still sticking out. These ones are hanging over the lower mouth like that. But you can see they're lipped here a little bit, and these lower teeth in particular are lipped. Whereas on this one, it's just this big, huge array of jagged teeth that are very barely covered by the dinosaur's mouth in the slightest. I prefer this design a lot more on the right. Couple of little things as well, the promaxillary fenestra, which is essentially a hole in the skull, is more pronounced on the ARK 2 Rex compared to the ARK 1 Rex, as you can see. And the same also goes for the inferior temporal fenestra, which is this sort of area back here on our ARK 2 Rex, and it's barely there at all on the ARK 1 Rex, kind of just filled with muscle and flobbiness. It's an official term, by the way. Not too much we can glean from the skeletal and the full design on this one. There isn't a fantastic shot of the full body ARK 2 Rex at this point in time. You know, we are going off trailers and concept art and stuff like that. We can dig into these more in the future. It's an interesting design. Again, I don't love the feather style of the feather coverage. This is how I would personally do feather coverage for a Rex in terms of the positioning. I wish it was a little bit less wild. I wish it has been toned down a little bit. They are humongous, but we'll have to see what it looks like when we get in game. I think the mouth and the skull shape is a lot better. It's definitely got a little bit of V-Rex to it, you know, a little bit of King Kong, a little bit of Crocodilian to it in some aspects, but overall, it's a pretty good design. It's bulky and thick and feels ominous in the way that a Rex should. This was a humongous barrel of a dinosaur, absolutely gigantic, and it should feel heavy and robust. And I think the ARK 2 version reflects that a lot better than the ARK 1 version does. Moving on now to Brachiosaurus. Now, Brachiosaurus is available in two different ways in ARK Survival Evolved. The first is in ARK Editions, which is a fantastic mod bringing in loads of new species that is very, very popular. And I believe it is officially sponsored by Studio Wildcard, but it is also a mod, so I didn't want to use that for the comparison. There is actually also a Brontosaurus costume that you could get from the archaeology event, and that will also make your Brontosaurus look like a Brachiosaurus. So I believe that's what I've got on the right-hand side. I really hope I haven't messed this up somewhere, because I don't know this that well myself. But the one on the right is the Brontosaurus costume that makes it look like a Brachiosaurus. So that is Studio Wildcard's own version, which I thought was the more appropriate comparison. So let's once again do a bit of a comparison here. First of all, the ARK 2 version is wild. It is covered to the nine in spikes and little details and little things sticking out all over the body, as you can see. We've got some osteoderms over here we'll talk about in a little bit. We've got three different levels of spikes going down here, down the neck, on the pouch under the throat. We've got some spikes there as well. We've got more spikes on the back of the head, whereas the ARK 1 version has basically none whatsoever. My favourite change from ARK 1 to ARK 2 is actually here. This is the sort of nasal chamber. This is what it would have used to breathe, largely. And I love that they've thrown in some colour and design onto there. Not there on the ARK 1 version. I know this is the basal model not coloured in, but it's not there anyway. They've thrown some colour in there. These would have often been used, we think, potentially as a display marker, so that makes a lot of sense. They've also moved, as you can see, I'll just move this away for a second. The nostril has been moved from up here to down here. So it was here on the ARK 1 version, and now it's here on the ARK 2 version. This idea that the nostril was placed on the nasal boss ridge breathing hump thing is an outdated idea. It used to be like posited as like almost like a snorkel. That is outdated, and the nostril has since moved back down to the lower reaches, which would be about there on the ARK 1 model. So again, that's a nice little nod to realism. And the eye has moved as well. You can see the eye on the right one is much lower down and to the right. On the left one, it's been moved up to more sort of this position over here. And in general, it's worth noting, yet again, it's a thicker dinosaur. The neck in particular, it's quite skinny here, and this sort of skin flaps on the right-hand side. Here, it's thick and robust in the way that a Brachiosaurus would be. The shoulders, much thicker, more rotund than we've got on the right-hand side as well. They've just thickened the dinosaur in general, and also covered it in osteoderms and stuff like that. You can see here we've got osteoderms there, bony plates covering the body. They are there on the ARK 1 version, but they're more prominent on the ARK 2 version, and again, we've got all these spikes. Now, Brachiosaurus probably did have osteoderms. We don't really have direct evidence for this, but we've got evidence for it in other, particularly smaller sauropods, and the spikes as well are definitely possible. You know, these dinosaurs would have had display features, and they would have been more elaborately built than they're often rendered in media. If you go watch Prehistoric Planet, for example, which, whilst it does take some liberties and pushes the boat out in some places, is still rigorously scientifically researched, and a lot of the sauropods have very elaborate display features, and they've got spikes, and they've got osteoderms, and stuff like that. So, whilst this ARK 2 version definitely looks more ARK-ish, given the huge number of spikes and stuff, I actually think it's probably closer to what the actual dinosaur would have looked like. And again, I really like it as a design. And just as an example here, you can see this is a really nice rendition of Ampelosaurus by a Russian artist. That's their name. I don't know what to do with that. I'm sorry. But by a Russian artist. And you can see the spikes going along the back rendered in this realistic manner. So it's definitely not as unrealistic as it may first seem. Right, moving on to the Ankylosaurus. This is the the nadir of the whole thing. This is going to look bonkers. So this is Ankylosaurus crassicutus, or crassicutus. This is the one from ARK 1. And the ARK 2 one is bonkers. That said, there are a couple little nods towards realism, even here in the ARK 2 Ankylosaurus. Well, let's go through and see what's changed in this new version. Of course, we've got the spikes are kind of more organically placed. They kind of more align with the curvature of the body in a more naturalistic way compared to these ones, which are splaying out all over the bloody place. That said, they're now comically humongous. They are absolutely gigantic. The same goes for here. Again, these kind of fit with the curvature of the body, with the curvature of the armor, but they've been tentupled in size. You know, they're, again, absolutely gigantic. The club is still not a club. For some reason, the club is more like a thagomizer. Now, there were ankylosaurids who had clubs that sort of resembled this. They were spikier, they're more elaborate, but Ankylosaurus, as far as we know, wasn't one of them. It had a more very traditional club sort of shape. This thing, again, is absolutely bonkers. It's just covered in gigantic spikes for some reason. It's just, like I said, I don't need my dinosaurs to be wholly realistic. I like the Stegosaurus design, for example, and by no means is that more realistic. But this is too far for me. This is crazy. I'm so curious as to how they're going to attach a saddle to this thing in ARK 2, because I don't see how it's possible. A couple nice changes over here at the front. You can see that the skull and the sort of nasal region in general is quite a lot thicker on this left-hand one on the ARK 2 iteration compared to the ARK 1 one, which comes to a very sharp point. And I would like to think Stegosaurus was probably a little bulkier in the skull. It does look a bit strange, though, it must be said. But another nod towards the actual dinosaur, this is the main one that I can see, really. If you look at how the plating joins with the body, Okay, I'm going to show you the skeletal first very quickly. Look at the skeletal for Ankylosaurus. Ankylosaurus has changed a lot over the last couple decades or whatever. In that, in the past, it was rendered more like, I'm going to draw an Ankylosaurus, you'd have, there's your body, and then you'd have this thick armor plating, and it would hang over the body, and then you'd have shadow here, because it's thick and it hangs over the side of the body, and it's kind of this big armor plating. Again, like you would see in Jurassic Park or Jurassic World. We know that's not what Ankylosaurus really looked like, and the plating was more built into the body itself, and the dinosaur itself would have been much more round. And you can kind of see that in the ARK 2 design. If you look at the edge of the plating here, you can see it kind of just blends down into the body. It's very clearly separate. These are the plates here. I do like how they're smaller, the plates as well, and more defined than the ARK 1 version, which again has that. You can see the shadow under there, so it hangs over the body. You don't have that in ARK 2. It does blend straight into the body, and then we've got these spikes at the side. So that's actually a really nice nod to the real dinosaur. I just wish they'd calm down on the spikes. I don't mind. You know what? I don't mind these. That's fine. There was ankylosaurids out there and stegosaurids out there that had these front-facing spikes like that. That's totally okay. I just wish this was more like a normal club, and I wish this was less utterly bonkers. Last one we're going to look at is the Dodo Raphus Replica. And pretty good one, actually, generally speaking. Some nice changes here for the ARK 1 and ARK 2 version. There they are, side by side. ARK 1 on the left, ARK 2 on the right. Let's have a little look at what's changed here. First of all, there's less flesh on the skull. I think you can see that, especially around the eyes and sort of that inner nasal region. It's a bonier looking skull. It's kind of, the skin is tighter to the bone on the face of the ARK 2 Dodo compared to the ARK 1 Dodo. The eye, again, I mentioned this earlier, but the eye on the ARK 2 Dodo is much larger. It's round. The eyelids aren't sort of half covering it. Again, this is probably a more realistic interpretation of the creature. I also think it gives it a little bit more personality. It makes it look a little goofier, but that really suits the ARK Dodo. The feathering's been made a little bit more elaborate on the back of the skull, but also sort of on the wings and on the tail, and here at the base of the neck. If I was on the right lab here at the base of the neck, a little bit more elaborate as well. And probably my favourite change between the designs other than the eyes is the way the beak has been smoothed out. You can see here on the ARK 1 Dodo, it's very up and down and up and down for some reason. It's all over the place. Gives it this kind of worried, bizarre kind of expression, where the ARK 2 Dodo is this lovely, smooth swoop. And I'm going to show you not a skeletal for the Dodo, but something else. We're going to look at some artworks, because the Dodo was only around 400 years ago. You know, it's not been extinct that long, all told. So we don't need to look at skeletons. We can look at actual paintings from relatively modern painters. So this is a painting by Roland Savary, sort of him. Roland Savary from 1626. And you can see here some similarities already, particularly the ARK 2 changes. One, we've got that large circular eye, and then we also have the swooping beak like that, rather than the ba 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 kind of beak. So those two nods are more realistic. The gathering of feathers here at the base of the neck as well, and the more elaborate sort of feathers here at the tail and on the wing. Doesn't have the sort of mohawk little bit, but that's okay. We can also look at this painting from Cornelius Sutherland from 1638. This is probably the latest painting ever of a dodo, as in of someone who's looking at a dodo and painting a dodo. So this is maybe the best one we're ever going to have at what this creature would have looked like. And again, the beak has that relatively smooth movement. The feathering on the back of the head is a little bit closer to this. They're not as large. This is not realistic, you know, these huge kind of individual feathers. It wouldn't really have looked like that, but it gives it a bit more personality, so I don't mind that. And I'd say you can see how this sort of bony appearance here more closely resembles the ARK 2 Dodo than it does the ARK 1 Dodo. ARK 1 Dodo is just really ugly. The more that, I really don't like the ARK 1 Dodo, but the ARK 2 Dodo is fantastic. I love that we can see this with the Dodo. It's kind of sad in a way to think that people were actually watching this animal live and being able to paint it like this in a way that obviously nobody else ever really could, but well, we murdered it, but it's fantastic that we can see that direct comparison. And again, the eye is very circular and round and unencumbered by eyelids and stuff like that. Much more like an actual blimmin' bird. There's a couple other dinosaurs spotted. Of course, we had our Archaeopteryx, but this is very, very blurry. We don't really have anything to go off here. And the cave drawings, of course, for the Parasaurolophus and the Triceratops. And that could be not the Utahraptor. That could be and a Bellosaurid or some description. I don't know what that would be. That could be a sort of medium-sized theropod over there. But it's a cave drawing. We're not going to evaluate a cave drawing too hard. And that is it from me. I've been talking for half an hour. I'm going to have to trim the hell out of this video. Well, that is my closer look at the ARK 2 dinosaurs and their designs. I hope you've enjoyed the video and this slightly in-depth look. I really like doing this kind of thing. I get to do research myself and I get to learn things along the way. I'm not going to say it's perfect, but trying. And yeah, let me know what you think. What's your favorite of these designs? I will say I like all of them except the Ankylosaurus. It's the only one I actively dislike. I think all the others are good. I'd make changes to the T-Rex and Stegosaurus as well, but I still like the designs. I think the Utahraptor is fantastic, and I think the Brachiosaurus is pretty great as well, and I really like the new Dodo. I think it's got more personality, whilst just generally speaking looking prettier, which is cool. yeah, let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video. From now on, when a new dinosaur for ARK 2 gets unveiled, we're going to talk about it right here on the channel. We'll announce it and we'll do some comparisons and stuff like that in a very similar vein to this. So hopefully the next time we do this, it'll be a much shorter video. But the first time, we had a lot to get through. Right, subscribe if you're new to the channel for more ARK 2 news, updates and analysis. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Let me know which your favourite and least favourite in the comment section. And I will see you lovely folks very, very soon. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.